Okay, that's you're talking to me moment.
You talking to me? You talking to me?
I suppose that this moment was a fun moment with the context. I'm not so sure now. But I wouldn't do it again, you know, like that, like. Do people know that they are talking about someone who is crazy and who wants to kill people?
Here's a man who would not take it anymore. A man who stood up against the scum, the cunts, the dogs, the filth.
Who had nothing in his life and who found one thing to do. You have your gun with you? Don't shoot just like that! Shoot at him! Do. What? You just killed someone. Are you all crazy?
I'm not sending you my address like I promised you last year. But the sensitive nature of my work for the government demands utmost secrecy.
Oh! Okay, he's lying to his parents about
and I know you'd be proud if you could see her. Her name is Betsy. I hope no one's died. Don't worry about me. One day there'll be a knock on the door and it'll be me.
No, police.
Love, Travis.
It's the only thing that you have, your television.
Please don't do this to me. I love him.
So now you're gonna be without the television, only with your mind and your thoughts?
See that guy over there?
Yeah.
You go talk to him, his name's Matthew. I'll be over there waiting for him.
Okay. If you want to save yourself some money, don't fuck her. We should be back here every night for some more matches. 12 minutes, if you're so you ain't never had no pussy like that. You
she's... Want how much? I'm depressed. He wants to kill you.
Is it really 12 and a half?
So, mister, it's your time. 15 minutes ain't long.
What's your name?
Easy.
Yeah. Is that any kind of name?
Well, that's easy to remember.
Yeah, well, what's your real name?
Iris.
Well, what's wrong with that? That's a nice name. Remember when you got into a taxi, it was a checkered taxi. You got in and that guy Matthew came by and he said he wanted to take you away. Do you remember any of that?
No.
She's sincere.
Oh, that's alright, I'm gonna get you out of here. Well, I don't want to make it all out of
health care.
Well, I can help you. Damn, man!
Damn it! Careful with the girl.
I can leave anytime I want to.
Then what about that one night?
I was stopped, so they just protect me from myself.
You really think so?
This is yours. Spend the right.
The one you are keeping during all this time.
You want me to go back to my parents? I mean, they hate me. Why do you think I split in the first place?
How old?
I don't go screw and fuck with a bunch of killers and junkies the way you do. You call that being hip?
So what makes you so high and mighty? Will you tell me that? Didn't you ever try looking at your own eyeballs in the mirror?
So what are you going to do about sporting that old bastard?
When?
When you leave.
I'll just leave him, I guess.
You're just going to leave?
Yeah, I got plenty of other girls.
Yeah, but you just can't do that. What are you going to do?
Sport never treated me bad. I mean, he didn't beat me up or anything like that once.
But you can't allow him to do the same thing.
That's a gentleman.
You can't allow him to do that. He's the scum of the earth. He's the worst.
Or you're planning to kill him.
Sucking scum I have ever seen.
I'll move up to one of them communes in Vermont.
I got something very important to do.
Also, what's so important?
Aha!
Doing some sort of government.
Yeah, well, that's what you're doing. You're going to be my woman.
You're a woman?
You never spend any time with me anymore.
You wish you were, don't you? You don't have to be away from you either.
That's how you catched them?
Come to me, baby.
You're disgusting. Such a manipulator. I love the flowers that you... I will be dead as... Okay.
There has been any choice for me.
The journey of the masculine. It's well done, it's really well done. But this is not what I was expecting for this Sunday morning. Ah! How about... Okay. And you didn't have him? No secret service to protect your spot.
Stuck
on this. Oh, 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 oh. Hey! Yeah! You shot him right there? So many guns! Like, all of you! You're gonna kill him now in front of her. Ooh. You wanted to kill yourself? You can't? You killed yourself? You wanted to, but you caused a lot of damage before that. Also what you wanted. That's a good shot. All of these zooms, you know, on the guns. To denounce them?
There is no way we can repay you for returning our Iris to us. She's back in school and working hard. Transition has been very hard for her, as you can well imagine.
You're an hero now?
Hello, Travis.
Betty? Now you're gonna consider him. How many different ends for this movie? I'm sorry. this movie could have had so many different ends, and it's clearly on purpose, you know. I'm wondering about the message at the end, you know, the morality of the story. It could have ended, you know, like, that was a journey of a mass killer, of a mass shooter. How a man can lose his mind, can be so lonely that one woman who rejected him really made him switch into that mass killer, and because of that he shot a politician in public and killed so many people. After that he could have ended, you know, just on the justice pages, new death on that pimp motel. Imagine how this guy coming from nowhere killed this man because he had a crush on a little girl. And finally, it's ending with the guy was an hero. He intervened, killed this guy, freed the girl, and her parents won't to thank him that much. Or, in fact, it was a romantic movie since the beginning and at the end, he got the girl. Or, it's the story of a guy who gets over a girl and is managing to reject the girl who rejected him. So many different stories. So many different ends, but how he's looking at her at the end, and really how all of this movie was built. For me, it was really the story of that guy who is suddenly lost with his own thoughts. You know, the fact at the beginning, the first scene, he wants to have something to do into his life during the night, to not have his thoughts, you know, like to not think too much. From the beginning, inside, it was not healthy, in my opinion. Like, he had some issues. All of these scenes, you know, with the music, with these streets, it was really to show how lonely he is. He's getting so obsessed with a girl just like that, just by watching her once. And after that, he's spying on her, he's obsessed with her, he's trying to analyze her life. He's going to have her like, no, you're not flirting like that with women. It was really like Joe, you know, in the show You, and we know how it ended for Joe. He's jealous, he's obsessed, he's taking her to a porno movie, he's threatening her, her life, at her job. At some point he's meeting a guy who wants to kill his wife. It enters into his head so much that he's buying all of these guns. He's gonna train with the guns, with his body and all, to at some point be able to kill a politician. And he's going crazy and crazy. He's trying to ask for some help to his friend, but clearly his friend is not that good. All of this story with Iris, clearly he wanted to help her, he wanted to save her, but again, as a lunatic, you know, like, coming from nowhere, after weeks, you know, with what happened with the cab, with her who was trying to get into the cab, of course she was not gonna remember you during that moment, of course she was gonna think that that's weird. You wanted to help her, you wanted to give her the money. When your first plan of killing people on the street didn't happen, you thought that, oh, I'm gonna help her, I'm gonna save her by killing all of these persons. You know, all along the movie, thinking about the fact that the story was about that, was about watching how someone can lose his mind so much that he's gonna commit that kind of killings, like that public, massive killings. I was like, that's rough in a way, that's bad, because we're watching that, because he's the main character, so we're supposed to understand him, understand his reasons. At the same time, I was like, it's great, you know, for a movie to show that, it's great for a movie to go with a story like that, to show it, to be also so clever with it, you know. he was too much, but the movie was not too much by showing all of his journey. The movie was not using too many big musics, too many things, you know, like it was really regular things that we watched about his life, you know, like regular moments. Just that moment, you know, with his television, like you can think that it was for nothing. It's a regular thing, it's not that important at all, but into the life of a person like that, that's important. So during all of the movie, I was like, it's interesting to see that, it's clever how it's done because it's not too much, it's not too impressive, you know, with how it's done and all. But it's also really good because we have a lot of good pictures, we have really a good interpretation with the actors. So I was like, yes, it's really great, it's really well done. If the story is that, the journey of a massive killer, how you can end up by doing that. But with a conclusion like that, with an end like that, I'm really disturbed a little, you know, by the morality of it. He planned to commit it, he didn't succeed, he committed other crimes, but he ended by being defined like an hero, and he is the one to reject the girl at the end, like, that's it. At the beginning of the movie, you know, with his story with her, I was like, am I supposed to appreciate that? Am I supposed to find him charming? Am I supposed to be like, oh, he's so sweet, okay, he doesn't know how to flirt with a girl, but it's not his fault. I was like, really, I have to be in his side? Because of that end, you know, because of this end with him not committing the crime, the first one, committing the second one, and being considered as a hero, and with that end, with the girl, like, he's rejecting him, I'm also like, am I supposed to be on his side? Am I supposed to consider him as a hero because he saved Iris, and in fact, he didn't commit these crimes, and he ended better, you know, than how he was at the beginning. He's into a better place and he's the one to reject the girl. He's an hero, a savior, and a good man at the end. Am I supposed to be on his side because of that at the end? No. But that's why also I appreciate that little thing at the end. That little moment with him looking at her like that, because it's making me think that I'm right to think that no, I shouldn't be on his side because yes, he's still a little like that into his head and maybe he's gonna do something else stupid, something else crazy, like it's not the end for a character like that, like no, it's not becoming a better man, it's not the end for him, you know? Oh, I was not expecting that, a movie like that. What a Sunday morning! For me, you know, I'm watching this movie, it's Sunday morning. I was not expecting that at all. And that moment, you know, I knew that it was coming from that movie, the "you're talking to me" moment. And you know, even if I never watched that movie, I already did that, you know, at least once into my life. And I thought that it was a funny moment. I thought that it was a funny line, you know, coming from a funny moment into a movie. Now that I know the context of that moment, I'm not sure that I'm gonna do it again. Because clearly during that moment he was going crazy and he was training to kill people into the street. He was living into a fantasy world. It's a really good movie. I understand why it's cult, I understand why people can like it. I understand also all of the cosplay. You know, because again, it's really clever how it's done, how they are representing the journey of that character, how they are representing how lonely he is. Really, for me, this movie is really about the loneliness of a guy. So yes, I truly appreciated the movie. I understand why it's cult. I'm disturbed by the end a little and I'm wondering about the morality of it, you know, the message at the end. You know, I'm pretty sure that I got it, but I'm not sure that everyone got it, you know, or at least that everyone has the same interpretation I'm sure that 90% of the people, we have the same interpretation of it. But you know, some extremist macho guys, I'm not sure that they have the same. That's why it's bothering me a little. Tell me, what did you think about this movie? Tell me, how did you interpret the aunt? Tell me, what do you think about all of these different aunts that he could have, and that finally he has that choice, you know, by the writers to make that aunt for that character, for that journey. I'm gonna go to search for opinions about this movie now that I can read them, you know. I didn't want to have any spoilers, so I never read any opinions, any reviews for this movie, but now that I can read them, I'm interested, you know, to see what people thought of this movie. Okay, I'm gonna end this review right now. Remember that right now on Patreon you already have my next reaction video about a movie that they chose on Patreon, and with an extended reaction part, and that if you want you can have an extended reaction part for that movie on my Patreon, which is waiting for you since 1 month now. So it's all for you and for me for today. So it's all for me for now. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me you built a time machine?
Great.